Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'm your brother Abu Talha Dhahak. Welcome all of you. We all know what's going on in Rohingya and Rakhine in the state of Burma and how Muslims are treated and Muslims are slaughtered in Burma and Rohingya. We all know about this fact. And if your heart doesn't cry for them, and if you don't feel for them, and if you don't empathize them, then you have to question your iman. Because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying that a Muslim is like a whole body. The Muslim Ummah is like the whole body. So if one part of the body feels pain, the whole body feels pain. So you have to feel the pain of the Muslims. And if you're not feeling the pain of the Muslims, then you have to question your iman. But now the question which comes here is sharing the images, sharing the photos and the graphical images, the videos of the people who are getting slaughtered in Burma and the Rohingya. I mean, when I open my Facebook and Twitter and when I go through my WhatsApp messages, I see lots of graphical images where I see the people are getting slaughtered, people are getting burned, people are burnt with the burning tires. I see people, you know, small children getting slaughtered. I mean, is it good enough to share these kind of pictures on the social media? We need to ask this question. Is it good enough to share this kind of pictures on the social media? The first and the foremost thing which you have to keep in your mind is that these images and these photos send a very wrong message. It sends a very wrong message. It really makes Muslims depressed. And to make Muslims depressed and to make Muslims demotivated in itself is a sin. You need to understand this. To make Muslims depressed and to make Muslims demotivated in itself is a sin. So when you share these kind of images and the photos and the graphical images on the social media, you're making Muslims depressed and you're making them demotivated, and this is what they want. And during the times of battles, during the times of wars, you mean, this is the strategy. What they do, they try to create the fear psychosis in the hearts of the enemies. In the hearts of the enemies, they try to create this fear psychosis, and this is what they are trying to do now by creating by sharing the graphical images of the Burmese victims on the social media. And the second thing which we need to ask ourselves and which you have to ask yourself is that in case the people who died and the people who died, suppose they are your relatives. If one of them is your wife or your children, do you like that people share her pictures on the social media? Do you like the lying corpses, the carcass? Do you like that the dead bodies of your relatives being shared on the social media, on WhatsApp and the Facebook and the Twitter? Do you like that? Do you like that your son is getting slaughtered and that picture and that video is getting shared on the social media? Do you like that? No, right? You don't like that. And third thing which you have to ask yourself is that you have to verify these pictures. You have to verify these photos. If you look carefully, many of them belong to Africa. Many of them belong to Ghana, and many of these videos and the pictures belong to, you know, Bangkok, Thailand, Philippines, China, Japan. And these people, I mean the Burmese, I met them in Hyderabad in 2012 I met them in Hyderabad, and there are about 40-50 families in Hyderabad, and alhamdulillah they have got the refugee status. And one of my friends, he worked hard and he went to meet Sonia Gandhi and he got them refugee status in Hyderabad. So when you meet them, they look like Indians. And their complexity, I mean their color and the way they look more like Indians. They look more like Bengalis. So they are not like Chinese, they are not like Filipinos. So these videos and the pictures and the photos which are shared on the social media, when you look at them carefully, you see that these pictures, some of these pictures belong to Philippines, Africa, Bangkok, Thailand. So what I'm trying to tell my dear friends is that before sharing these pictures, try to verify it. And don't just straight away share it. It doesn't look good. It really gives a very wrong message. It really gives a negative signal. And it makes Muslims, demotivated. And many of these pictures are so disturbing that when you watch them, you really lose your mood. I mean, decapitating, beheading, burning alive, and burying alive. I mean, these pictures are so disturbing. I recommend you, please do not share it on the social media. Please don't do it on the social media. If you really care for them, go to the masjid and wake up for Fajr, pray Qunut Nazila, and pray Qunut Nazila and Isha. If you really care for them, do this. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did this. And when 70 Sahaba, they were killed through deception, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he prayed for them. He cried and he prayed for them. And if you really feel for them, if you empathize them, then wake up for Fajr, wake up for Tahajjud, and pray for them. But sharing these kind of pictures on the social media won't do any good, won't help you. And in fact, it gives a very wrong message. That's what I'm trying to say. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.